Yeah, so we were talking about before, the reason that we're doing this is to try and help other business owners that are kind of, or people with a goal or a dream that are kind of in that same situation where they're like ready to take that step, but maybe they're not sure if they can do it, or maybe they have just one or two things holding them back, or, you know, they're just unsure if they can pull it off even, right? Because for me, in my life, the most important thing that I had, and I assume you're the same from hanging out with you, is just that, like, I had a dream that pushed me to be better all the time. From as far back as I can remember, the first time I went to a professional soccer game in England, from that moment on, I was a professional athlete.
Right.
And just having that mindset of whatever sport I took on next was like, I'm going to be a professional. I'm going to be paid to do this. People are going to look up to me as an athlete, and this is what I'm going to do. And the goal eventually became go to America, go to the NBA, and make millions of dollars, be on TV. That's, you know what I mean? That was a dream. And 5'9", being from England, it wasn't a, no one would say that's a logical thing to even aim for.
Got
laughed at. You know, most people, I was too busy working to get there that I even knew people were laughing about it. But there was, you're aware of how people think about your goals and your dreams, right? Especially people that don't have them. Kind of like, especially in England too, it's like, who do you think you are? Why do you think you can go and do that?
Right.
So, for you to have done what you've done in your life, there had to be an underlying dream there, right? You started off working with your dad.
Yep.
And then
I stopped completely, and because music took over my life.
Yeah.
20 years, and it still does. And it was kind of a similar story of yours, like you run into people that are, you know, when you're young, you care about what people think about you and all that, and you run into people that think you can't do that, or you can't do this, and blah, 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 and I'm going to say, I said, I'm going to play with this guy, I'm going to play with that guy, and people laugh at you, and then you end up playing with those people, you know?
Yeah.
And then it got to a point that I didn't care anymore about any of the glamorous life or any of the thing, but just the music.
Okay.
And then I started paying attention to the actual music that I was playing. It was maybe 20% of the rest of the work that I was doing. So part of opening this business is also to continue music in a more pure way when I can pick and choose the things I want to do.
Yeah.
And the other part of the dream is that owning a coffee shop and owning a bar was always a thing that I had in mind. It was just, you know, before I was focused in music, and then when I realized that it was time to change, I put my foot down and I said, let's do this.
Yeah. And so what was the original dream for you music-wise? Where did you want to be? Like, was it where you ended up, or was it much bigger than that at first?
Ended up being much bigger than I thought it would be.
Do you think you would have got to where you were if you didn't have that in mind? Or, like, it didn't happen by accident?
It wasn't. I mean, I believe in one thing, that's like, luck exists, but you have to be ready to accept it when the opportunity comes.
Yeah.
You can't just wait around. So yes, there's luck on everybody's side. You know, there's luck that we've met.
Right.
There's moments that, but you seize that opportunity, you need to be ready for it. You always need to be prepared for a better opportunity or for a bigger opportunity.
And I think there's some parallel between, like, the sport that I was playing was, as much as it's a team sport, it's very individual.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, your skills are, there's five people on a team, your skills have to be the right skills to fit into that team.
Exactly.
With you with drums, it was percussion, it was, your skills have to be at this point to then fit into the bigger band, right?
Yeah, and then you also have to meet the right people, and this guy actually talks about you to this guy, and that guy had to call that person for you to get that gig, you know? And it's like this snowball effect, you know? And you start working, and you get the calls and you do the gigs. And you know, I've done, dude, I am so lucky. I'd say that I was lucky in certain points, but I don't believe that that was the only thing. That there's no way somebody's just lucky and gets stuff done.
And how hard, you know, did you have to work to get to that level?
Like, as hard as I'm working right now here. Mm-hmm. Just, I mean, yeah.
And it was just you and the instrument.
Me and the instrument, me in the studio, me on the road, me practicing, me rehearsing, me learning a song, me in school, learning how to read music, me driving 3 hours for a gig that didn't pay, me doing this, yeah, just 16 hours a day for 20 years.
And that's the thing that, you know, like, without that, knowing that this is where I'm going to be one day, it doesn't just happen, right? Like, you can't just... Because, I mean, for me, it was 16 years old, sneaking into school before the cleaner got there. Mm-hmm. Because I knew they left the gym door open. The PE teacher saying, you can't come in because we're not insured. You know what I mean? But me finding a way in no matter what. Then by the time the teachers get to school, it's too late because I'm in there working out. You know what I mean?
Right. Like,
and other people... Outside, I'm outside in the rain for hours shooting a basketball because I don't have an indoor court, so that's my only option. And the whole time you're imagining yourself on that stage, right? The whole time I'm imagining myself playing in the NBA.
Yeah, you have
and
to.
Nothing in my mind told me that I wasn't going to go there. You know, it was like, at 18, I'm going to America. And people are like, how? Well, how's that going to happen? You know what I mean? And for you, it was like, I'm going to be on stage with these people. And now you look back and you've done, like, Saturday Night Live. You know what I mean? Things like that, like...
Yeah. I mean... I don't know, man. It's just... I think you... There's a thing about... That my dad said to me a while... I mean, 20 years ago, it's like... You dream with your... You dream... Your heads are in the cloud, but your feet are on the floor. Mm-hmm. On the ground. You need to be grounded at all times, but you cannot stop going up.
Yep.
It doesn't matter what is up to you. If it's just doing a bigger one, getting a better job, or not getting a better job, just staying where you are, but going up here. So you're happy about yourself and you have something to look for. I mean, happiness is you looking for something different, right? And changing yourself. When you're just coasting in life, life sucks. I mean, we've been to that moment where you're coasting at some job or some girlfriend, ex-girlfriend, whatever, that you're not happy.
Yeah.
So it needs to be a constant change for you to be happy. It's the journey, right?
Well, and that's the reality of the situation. It's like when you said you've got to be dreaming, but your feet are on the ground. I don't know if you run into this now with this place, but with the gym and with everything that I've done before, like I started a basketball academy. And people used to come and say, like, must be great to run that basketball academy.
No,
you know what I mean? And it was 18 hours a day trying to get these, doing everything for no appreciation. You know what I mean? And then the gym on top of that, people are like, must be great to have a gym. Like, that's my dream. People will say to you all the time, it's my dream to have a bar and a coffee shop.
Go do it.
But the point is the execution of it, right? Like, it was a dream to go to the NBA, but then I had to put in 10 hours a day on the court, on my own, in the rain, and it's the same for you. It's like, do you think without that, you could have opened this business? You could have even thought about it.
No way. You gotta execute. Yeah. You gotta go in and do it.
Yeah.
And I mean, you gotta be a little. You know, you gotta be a little crazy to do that, man. Yeah. Like, you can't. You gotta go above and look, you know, a couple of years in front of you.
Yeah.
You know, and take chances and put everything you got to make it happen.
I don't quite think people understand when they say things like that to you when you have a business. And like when they say things like that to you when you achieve what you achieved as a musician, how disrespectful it is when they say stuff like, it must be nice, or like, I wish I could be lucky to be there.
How did you get that gig?
Yeah.
How did you get to open this place?
I don't think they understand it. Because it's like, I look at it as the equivalent. I don't think people even, like, me saying, I had the idea for the iPhone.
Right. Yeah, like, right. Sure.
So what? You didn't make an iPhone. You didn't have the technology. You didn't even, I had an idea for an iPhone before they created it.
Right.
I thought, wouldn't it be great to have a computer on your phone?
Yeah.
That's not the difficult part. You know what I mean? Like, that's not the hard bit.
No.
It must be great to have gone and played with NBA players. It must be great to have to have a gym where you own the place. And you're like, no, it's a lot of fucking work.
Right.
But I don't know any other way. You know what I mean? Right. So like,
it's easy for people to say that. I mean, it's easy for them to say that. And you, mm-hmm. I mean, it's not, you know, it doesn't even cross my mind. It's just like, yeah, no, some people don't want to do that. I have a good friend of mine that came in here. He's like, dude, congratulations.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to do this, but I'm not cut out for this. Mm. And that was the first time I was like, man, thanks for saying that.
Yeah.
Like, he realizes the amount of work it takes, and he knows, you know, although he didn't go through, at least he has an idea how much work it is to do.
And so, like, why can you take that? Like, what? Why are we built for that? Why do we want that pressure?
Why do we want that pressure?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I just like that's a good question. Why do we like that pressure? I think it's, first of all, I think people that like that, doing something better for yourself and foreseeing the future, you know. It got to a point in the music business that I saw what it could be done, and I have a kid and I have a wife, and I was like, 20 years from now, we're not going to be good. You know, that's one thing. But it's not the financial aspect of it. It's the actual experience that I want to show to my son of what we went through together. Because, yeah, I've done the music stuff. Yeah. That's already, I've done it. I could do it again, mm-hmm. I can continue to do it, and it's awesome. And I'm gonna continue to love and play music forever. It's not gonna change that I opened this place.
Mm-hmm.
And, but telling him 20 years from now that he could possibly be a manager here and teach him how to be responsible through this, the same way my dad did, that's what I wanna do for him. You know, I think it's about that more than about the money or about anything, but the experience that you can do different things in life as long as you do it with passion, with love, and you apply yourself for it. Yeah. I want him to be hardworking and honest, you know. And so this is mostly for him.
And did you always, because you're a very friendly person, you have a lot of people around you. Do you have a lot of close friends, or did you always feel like you were a little bit different, like you had to go and do this, or you were too busy, or you were...
I have a lot of friends and don't have time for them right now, mm-hmm. you know, but yes.
When have you ever had time for them?
Yeah, you're right.
Okay.
You're right.
Because it's kind of like you have a lot of connections, right? Mm-hmm. But not necessarily many close friendships that, like, people hang out a lot. But when you've got this drive and this passion to go and do certain things,
you have to manage your time, man. You can't just hang out all day with somebody. Not that I don't want to.
Right.
Shit, I would love to spend a day with my friends, go out hiking or whatever. Mm-hmm. Don't got time. I don't have time to do it.
Yeah. Just don't. But is there a certain part of you that kind of accepts that?
Yeah, of course.
Because I think I'm the same. Like, this is the path I'm choosing.
No, and they understand. Yeah. If they're my friend, and they do understand. Yeah, right. They come in here, they know. It's like, I know we got to record that record. There's 3-4 records in the studio to be done.
Mm-hmm.
They know that I'm busy. They're like, just get through the first 3 months, and then let's find a couple of days and finish it.
Yeah.
Those are my friends.
Yeah.
You know, they get that this is important. They
so
get
your friends are the people around you that drive you to be better. You don't have time to be around someone that's not going that way
you shouldn't have time to do that anyway. I mean, even if you had the time to spend with somebody that doesn't have your interest at best, that's not friendship, right? Friendship is when you respect and support the other.
Yeah.
Even if it's your wife or your girlfriend, friendship comes from that, right? You need to be helping
each other better.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I mean, if your friend is not doing that for you and they don't understand that and get upset at you, they're not your friend.
But that, I, in a way though, that kind of makes it hard to find people to be friends.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, I count my friends in one hand.
Right.
Yeah.
And because you do things with so much passion, driven that way, when people, you are that passionate in your friendships, you're that passionate in your marriage, you can't be athlete like this over here and a businessman here, and then I half go in on a relationship. I'm all in every situation. Oh, yeah. I'm all in on a friendship. You know what I mean? And it's like...
Yeah, you have to devote yourself for that, man. You're right. I mean, it's important to keep, you know, we were talking about self-care. You know, it's important to keep yourself okay so you can, you know, have a happy life, so you can have a happy wife and a happy kid and a happy friends and a happy place.
Yeah. I mean, business. And it's prioritizing things. Like, I don't know how you feel about this, but like, growing up as an athlete, I have to have a certain amount of athleticism in my day, no matter what. You have to have a certain amount of music in your day, I assume.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
And so like, that has to be there for me to be a good husband. And then I have to be driving for something better every day to be a good husband. Mm-hmm. There's times when my wife would be like, can you go to the gym and come back in a better mood? Because I know you need that, right? And it's like, how do you balance that stuff now?
Man, it's now that's my main concern with myself, man. Like, balancing, finding time to be, I mean, self-care is my number one on my list when I wake up and I read something. It's like, take care of yourself.
How long has this business been open now?
6 weeks.
Okay.
So, I mean...
How long have you been working on it?
A year. August last year. Yeah, so 12, 13 months.
So you're in year number one. You're in a stage where it's supposed to be like this, right?
Yeah,
right?
It is supposed to be like that. Yeah. I accept that. Yeah. I totally understand that this is what it needs to be done.
Yeah.
But it's coming to a place that if I don't fix self-care, everything will crash.
Exactly.
You know, you have to do that.
Yeah.
And I realize, you know...
But you can see how people do something like this and their relationship break down and their body breaks down and their mind breaks down because...
Exactly.
But then coming from where you are, you have that discipline from being a musician. Can you apply that to this? Like, I need to practice this to get to this.
Oh, right? Yeah. Like, I mean, discipline of... Yeah, you have to... Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
You know, being prepared, being on time, all those things that you need to...
I saw that was one of your mottos, right? It's like, always be on time and always smile. And every time I've met you or seen you, you've been smiling, number one.
Try to be on time.
And then when you have a lot of things going on, it's hard to be on time, but you understand the value of being on time. It's just like, you said that was one of the secrets to your success, right?
Yeah.
Is like, people know they can rely on you. Right. And when you show up, you're gonna brighten the whatever room you're in. You're not gonna come in there and then be negative, right?
Right.
And then is that the kind of way you choose people to be around?
Oh yeah. Yes.
So what's the key to the people that are around you now?
Positive attitude is number one, dude.
And that says
that
a lot.
You can do anything with that, dude.
Yeah.
Positive attitude, positive energy. You can shape anything however you want with that. You know, you can, I mean, that's, with that comes with being humble, comes being honest, right?
Yeah.
Because positivity carries all that.
Yeah.
And so if you're training somebody and you're being positive, maybe if you're not in that mood and you don't like expose that energy to them, then that person doesn't accept that information that way, right? If I'm training somebody here, or if I'm training somebody in the truck, right? But if I come here in a bad mood and I am mad because they don't do that, dude, that's ignored energy. That's it's not usable.
Yeah.
You know, it's just wasted time.
Right.
So I think that's the main thing you've got to keep focused on. I mean, when you're trying to do this, you're dealing with 25 people, 30 people. Keep it positive. Still relay the message that you need to relay to the employees or whatever, or to your friends or to. But if you don't do it that way, it doesn't go further, man. It doesn't go ahead. Mm-hmm. It just stays stuck.
Yeah.
And it's a problem that becomes a loop, and then you're wasting your time and energy on that.
Right. Yeah. So. Talk to me about failure.
Every day there's failure. Mm-hmm. You just gotta fix it and go through it.
How do you see failure? Like, what, not even necessarily here, but like in your life, what have been the things that have you because for me, experiences of failure have been what I think have shaped me the most.
Failure is growth. It's part of life, man. You gotta get through it, fix it, and go.
Yeah.
And it, I mean, just
can you think of any big ones that like could have either broken you or could have, you know, changed the direction, but you were like, no, this is where I learned.
So many, dude.
Yeah.
I mean, so many.
Do you think that's why you can then go and do things like this? This is why you can open this, because you've gone through that failure, so you're like, well, hey, I gotta just go.
Yes. So, yeah, absolutely. That's what shapes you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, come on, you gotta tell me one. Yeah.
Oh,
you got
man.
Me interested now.
Damn. All right. I'll share a family experience here mm-hmm. with you. My dad was an outstanding man, and he went through deep depression when I was between like 9 and 14 years old. And, you know, I saw my mom and my dad's marriage break down. My mom is an awesome mom. My dad's an incredible dad. And we had an incredible family. Mm-hmm. We still do. But at that moment, things broke down where, and my two brothers were away, and I was kind of holding it down there with them. So I saw that happen in front of my eyes for 4 years, 5 years. You know, my dad literally couldn't get up on the bed.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to become a man. You know, you have to become the man of the house at that moment to do anything, you know, to go get groceries, to go help your mom, to start working. You know, I started working when I was 13.
Yeah.
And a candy store to help out and to you know, be a man in the house. You shape yourself that way. Otherwise, mm-hmm. you just become a drug addict or whatever else.
Yeah.
Whatever the other option is available in front of you, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, part of being shaped to the right side is because of the family that I had before and the support that I had before.
Yeah. Know?
But failure, I'd say that's a failure that happened in the family. That was the biggest one, I'd say.
And but from it taught 13, you so much about work ethic, about you got to keep going. Like, you could sit and be like, well, dad's supposed to be doing this.
Yeah. And my dad was the hardest working man and the most honest man I've ever met.
And you know? Just hit a wall.
He just hit a wall. He was part of his life, right? But when you're 13 to 18 going through that, it's like, dude.
Why me?
Right.
Right.
Well, yeah, it's why
my
me, but it's also
that,
like,
yeah.
Dude, I gotta fix this, you know? And you fix it. And you get through the other side, and you look at your friends, and like, your friends have a great life, and they're like, wow, but these guys are like, kind of immature, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
At that point,
yeah.
5 years later.
Yeah.
So I think that was the biggest shaping thing that happened, for sure.
Yeah.
And it stays with me today. I mean, when I opened the shop too, all the stuff that my dad taught me before that, when I was working with him, dude, all with me, you know? And I tell him every day when I talk to him, he's like, man, remember when he taught me how to count the cash
mm-hmm.
and put this together and organize the fridge and all that? The little things that he shaped me that I had no idea that was gonna
come back. And so do you feel like this now is kind of like a tribute to him?
Part of it, for sure. And I mean, it's gonna be a thing for my sons, right? It's like a cycle of life
yeah.
that we're kind of trying to
yeah,
help
yeah.
each other out.
What did you learn about, you know, depression and things like that when he was going through that?
I learned to not think about it and not go down that, you know, there's, if you want to be depressed, you can get depressed. Dude. It's just go find the negative things in life and focus on that, and you're gonna get depressed.
Yeah.
Just stay away from that.
Especially
fix it and go.
Especially as a business owner, right? Because it's all
yeah.
on you.
There's every
no,
day something happens.
It's
or
the beauty of not having your own business is that, and I think it's a lot of people get that way, is they can blame someone else. Oh, the fucking boss made me do this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but when it's your business, it's always your fault, no matter mm-hmm. what happens. So you can take that and be like, every day it's my fault.
Mm-hmm.
It can get on you, right? But if you're like, well, what's the worst that happened that day? Is it that serious?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we keep moving on.
Right.
What's
exactly.
the positive today? You have a staff meeting, somebody can't show up. They don't show up. You're like, damn, for not showing up. But then you're like, look who did show up, right? And it's how you phrase it to yourself,
exactly.
right? It's like, well, one person out of eight didn't show up, but 7 out of 8 did.
Right.
So what am I going to do? Be pissed at the one? Right. Or am I going to respond and make
exactly.
the 7 out of 8 the people that I want to be around?
Right. You don't focus on that that customer that came in, and that, you know, you don't focus on the fridge being broken, focus on that customer that came in and said, dude, I love your spot, this coffee's great. You know, and that's what, that really is awesome, man.
Yeah.
The meeting of the people from the construction before we opened to opening and meeting the customers and meeting the staff, man, meeting great people. I made friends already. You know, I know that I'll be friends with these guys for a while, man.
Yeah.
You know, it's not forever. That is the point. So that is the point.
So what is it? Like, is it just accepting? How do you, because it's not being delusional, right? It's because the fridge is always going to be fucking broke.
Yeah, something will break.
And like, as you know, like I listen to a lot of different speakers, like something bad's going to happen. Like someone's going to die or someone's going to, and you have to like, that can't define you, right? When you have a business and you have people around you, someone's always going to fuck up. So if your emotions are like this, based on someone fucking up, then you're always in tune to them. But if you're just like, well, I got to live this way, no matter what happens. When did you learn that, do you think? Because I think I'm only
just learning
that.
Right. I'm only just learning that.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm still on the, there are days that, man, yeah, I'm still on the roller coaster, but I'm realizing that that doesn't work. Mm-hmm. I mean, gotta be just yourself and stay steady. It's also an example for whoever's working with you, right?
Yeah.
You don't want to be the guy that's stressed out and mad and angry,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
You don't want your place to look like that at all. Not at all. That's the last thing I want, man.
Yeah.
The first thing I want is people to feel happy and good here. So you need to be that, so, and lead by example, so everybody that's in here is the same way, right?
So, I mean, to me, what you're saying is like, that's the first point of leadership in an organization, is that you, no matter what, are the same person every day. So like when you walk in here, they're like, the boss is here. This is good. Not fuck. Sure.
Right. Trying to do that. Yes.
Yeah. But like that is tough when you look at them and they're like, all they have to do is come in and work today. They don't understand. I got this. The fridge is broken. I got to pay this guy. This.
Right.
Oh man, I got to post on social media. I got to.
Right.
But if you keep pointing, it's easy to go that way, right?
It is.
It's easy to. It's not easy to choose that way because it's depressing, right? But if you can go the other way and force a smile, right?
Yeah, that's, and then the it fixes difference. Itself, right?
Yeah.
Come on in.
Okay. Oh no, you good? You can order right there. Yeah.
No, but that is true, man.
Yeah. All right. So, the thing that we might have covered this a little bit before, but like, why you? Why do you deserve to have a place like this? Why did you go for it?
Why did I go for
it? Why do you think you can?
Because I can. It's that simple. I can do it. I can take it. I can do it.
And has there been any moments when you question that?
I don't question that.
Yeah.
That is never a question.
Yeah.
You got to be sure that you can do it.
Where does that come from, do you think?
I have no idea, dude.
Is that just life experience? Does that come from literally being 13 years old? And it's like,
exactly,
you're the man of the house now. And you don't have a choice. You got sisters, brothers, people around.
Yes,
and then
absolutely.
Just keeps
comes from
snowballing
that.
Into the
nothing notes. Else has been as close as ours to that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, yeah.
If I can take that, I can do it. Yeah.
If I didn't have that experience, I wouldn't be sitting here with you right now. I'm confident of that.
And when you were in that, how did you act?
When I was in that situation,
Did you still know that you were gonna live up here, or was it still like, did you think like, man, this might be
it?
I
don't know. I mean, I was 15, you know. I don't know. I wanted to be a musician. I wanted to do well. I wanted to be successful. But, you know, at that moment, I was just trying to juggle the family situation.
Do you think you got through that because you had that, though? What if you didn't have the musician thing?
Yeah, you're right. I mean, I could have. Yeah, music and the family for sure. Music and family, and my family's incredible, man. It's like, and my wife and her wife's family too, we are matched in that sense where our family support is incredible.
Yeah.
But yes, music was definitely a part of it.
Because the goal,
if that time that I was feeling frustrated, if I wasn't playing music or listening to music at those days, I mean, I don't know, man, I could have been doing something else.
That's it, because I remember I had the worst jobs to support this dream You know, it was like I'd be working all over the place. And I'd have some of the worst jobs. I'd be working, you know, in painting houses, landscaping. And then at the end of the day, still 3 hours of training, 3 hours of training in the morning before I went to these places because of that goal. And now as I get into this, it's like, this is what I do.
Right, that's what you wanted to do.
And so now I remember one big moment for me was I had the basketball academy running and I had the gym open at the same time and I was going to try and do both. And it was literally 5 a.m. coach class all the way till 9 a.m. 9 a.m. go pick up the academy players, take them to the gym, work them out for 5 hours. 2 o'clock, come back to the gym, I work out. 5 o'clock till 7:30, coach. 8 o'clock till 9 o'clock, business. 9 till 10, website, everything else that has to be done. You know what I mean? And for 6 months it was that. And I remember one time Lauren looking at me and I looked like you do now, exhausted, bags under my eyes. And she looked at me and she said, are you okay? You know, literally like, are you okay?
Right.
And I was like, the only reason I'm okay is because I know it would break most people.
Right. Exactly.
So I'm good. Because I look and I'm like, I don't know anybody that could handle this right now.
Right.
And fuck, I'm going to handle this.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
And so like when you were with your family in that point, it was like, most of these kids won't do this. They won't go work in a candy shop to...
No. No, absolutely not.
So that's how I know now this is going to be. No matter what happens here, you'll find a way.
Exactly.
Right? And is that how you feel?
Yeah, all the time. That's a constant right there.
Yeah.
The confidence that this is going to work is...
Never
there. Not even a question. It's going to work. Until... Dude, it's going to work. I can't even say it out loud that it's not gonna work.
Right.
It was never a thing that's like, oh, it's not gonna work. No, it's gonna work.
And where's the dream now? Where do you see it going next?
Oh man. I just want people to sit here and have fun and have a good time, get off their phones and talk to each other, share meals, share coffee, share drinks,
mm-hmm.
and get out of here and feel inspired by something. Yep. If it's one of the records they found or somebody else that was sitting here and they started talking to the manager, the owner, the kitchen guy, whatever it is.
Yeah.
Something that inspires them to do something cool and fun, or if they are inspired by opening a coffee shop, hell yes. Mm-hmm. I'll be there to support them.
Right.
Like whatever it'll be to inspire them, that's what this is about, you know.
If I can do it, you can do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah. Well, I mean, so I just want to basically end it just by, you know, talking about you for a minute. Like I met you 2-3 months ago, and to see what you've created here I think is incredible.
Thanks, man.
I think we have a very similar vision of what we want to create. It's not about money. We want to create a business that sustains itself, but it provides something to the community, right? And mm-hmm. this is a place where the moment you walk in, your personality is all over the place. You
Man, know, it's good like to hear that, for real.
Everybody that, the staff, everybody that is the same, they care about the coffee as much as they care about saying hello, right? And I think the hello sometimes is more important than the coffee.
Absolutely.
And
it is more important.
Everybody that meets you feels that same way. You make people feel like you're friends right away, you know? And with that attitude, I think whatever you do next is going to be amazing, and I hope that I'm along for the journey at some point with you. Like whatever we can do together. I mean, when you've met someone that is going to be in your life for a while, right? And
that's
if you're
right.
part of my circle, like that would mean a lot to me just to have you around. So
yeah, same here.
Great to
we know that.
Great to chat, and thanks for teaching me how to make my new favorite drink.
Yeah, you can make it at home now.
I'm gonna make it at home.
That's right.
But no, I'm gonna come here.
That's right.
Why would I make it?
Yeah,
imagine you come in, I'm just behind the bar.
Hey, Rafa, what are you doing? I'm making myself a drink.
You told me how to make it.
Charge me half price.
Cool, man. Well, thank you.
Yeah, thank you,
man.
I
appreciate
you. Blessed.
And I can't wait to keep working with you.
So. Appreciate it. Me too.
Thanks,
I will learn a lot just talking with you.
Good.
It's always a learning experience.
Yeah, that's what I'm here. That's what I'm trying to do.
It's good.
Figure out what makes you special and how I can apply it to my business. And I appreciate you.
I'll come back more often.
Nice.
Let's just chat without this. Thanks, bro.
Cool, man. Thanks.
It was fun, man.
I appreciate it.
Yeah.
That was good.